Everyone loves learning about English. This statement is an example of a logical fallacy. According to the Bedford Guide for College Writers, 10th edition, logical fallacies are common mistakes that may lead to wrong conclusions or distort evidence. Although it may be difficult for us at the Gaston College Writing Center to imagine that this statement is not true, there are individuals who do not enjoy learning about the English language as much as we do. This particular logical fallacy is called allness. According to the Bedford, allness is defined as stating or implying that something is true of an entire class of things, often using all, everyone, no one, always, or never. This is one example of the many logical fallacies we will discuss today. As an academic writer, it is important to avoid these fallacies so as not to lead your audience astray, distract or distort logic, or undermine the argument of your paper. Because of time, we will not be able to discuss all of the various logical fallacies, but we'll focus on the most common types. To begin with, hasty generalization is a common logical fallacy. This fallacy occurs when the writer draws a hasty or quick conclusion when there is not enough evidence to back up that conclusion. For example, my mail was delivered late 3 days this week. Therefore, my mail carrier is lazy. This is a hasty generalization because there is not enough evidence to prove that the mail carrier is lazy. There could have been excess traffic on those particular days. The mail carrier's car could have had trouble. Or the mail carrier could have been ill and there was a temporary replacement unfamiliar with the mail routes. It is important to have appropriate information to back up a claim. Another common fallacy is the either-or fallacy. According to the Bedford, this fallacy is defined as oversimplifying by assuming that an issue has only two sides. For example, what do you think about genetically modified food? Either you're for it or against it. This statement limits the reader to only two choices, but the reader's actual answer might be much more complicated. Another fallacy, known as post hoc ergo propter hoc, occurs, according to the Bedford, when one assumes a cause and effect relationship where none exists, even though one event preceded another. For example, there was a full moon last night, and my cat also had kittens. Therefore, my cat had her kittens because there was a full moon. There is not enough evidence to support the claim that the full moon caused the cat to have kittens. Therefore, it cannot be assumed that there is a correlation. The next fallacy is known as circular reasoning. An example of this would be the sentence, "Circular reasoning is reasoning that is circular." In other words, circular reasoning occurs when you attempt to explain or define something in terms of itself. Sometimes, circular reasoning is called begging the question. These terms are closely related and are often used interchangeably. Although these fallacies might take some time to learn, English is a great subject. This statement is an example of our next logical fallacy, the red herring. The Wadsworth defines this fallacy as changing the subject to distract readers from the issue. What may be the supporting statement, that English is a great subject, is distracting from the primary point of the statement, that logical fallacies might take some time to learn. The idea that English is a great subject does not directly relate to the time spent learning it. Our next fallacy is called the bandwagon fallacy. This occurs when the writer attempts to say that a piece of information is valid because everyone else believes it. For example, all Americans know that football is a better sport than baseball. In this sentence, the writer assumes that if all Americans believe that football is the better sport, it is evidence enough to support the claim that it is better than baseball. The writer expects the reader to join the majority in believing that football is better than baseball. It is important to note that the example statement also demonstrates that fallacy of allness. It is not uncommon for fallacious statement to include two or more logical fallacies. Cam Newton is not a good football player because he behaves immaturely during press conferences. This is an example of our next fallacy, ad hominem. This occurs when a writer attacks an individual or group's character rather than the actual claim. Acting immaturely during press conferences has nothing to do with Cam Newton's ability to play football. Our next logical fallacy is called straw man. Here, a person uses an exaggerated characteristic of an individual or group of people in order to invalidate an argument. The straw man fallacy is an attempt to discredit the individual's ability to make a believable claim by disparaging something about that individual. For example, John is the loudest, most annoying person on the planet. He clearly doesn't know anything about how to fix a car, is an example of the straw man fallacy. John's unpleasant personality has no bearing on his knowledge of automotive mechanics, and, therefore, cannot be used to discredit his skills in that department. Our final logical fallacy is called the slippery slope. This occurs when a seemingly small claim is made, and the counterclaim jumps to an extreme level in order to discredit the initial claim. I can't let my child have one piece of candy because that might cause him to eat absurd amounts of sugary foods, become obese, and get diabetes. This is quite a jump to say that eating one piece of candy will automatically lead to one child being diagnosed